walking down the aisle, first thing I saw was the back of his head. I mean, it just jumped right out at me. I recognized the hair pattern on the back of his head where his hair starts. You know where those two little points meet and it's darker than the rest? I always thought that was so sexy about him. And I looked at him during the ceremony and something about the way the light hit his face, oh, it broke my heart. And then outside, I see him talking to this total bitch in a navy blue linen dress with absolutely no back. I mean, you could literally see her butt. And he was smiling at her with that smile. That same smile that used to make me feel like I really meant something to him. And then it all came back to me. Just bam! All those times I waited for him to call me back, me going out of my way to make things more convenient for him, having to take a fucking taxi to the women's health center that day because it was so cold my car wouldn't start, and then later, that awful, awful day, I just sat in his driveway, just staring at Tracy's burgundy cutlass, just wishing I was dead. You know, I started smoking cigarettes that night. If I ever die of lung cancer, I swear it's going to be Tommy Valentine's fault.
You're just being really overdramatic and self-indulgent.
You think I want to feel like this?
Nobody's making you.
Whatever. Enough about me. Let's talk about my dress. I mean, can you believe Tracy made us wear these things?
Yes.
Of course, I can't believe she asked me to be in her wedding.
I can't believe you said yes.
What was I supposed to say, Trisha? Tracy, I don't think I could be in your wedding because you remember that time I had that nervous breakdown my junior year of college? Yeah, that was because your boyfriend knocked me up and I had to get an abortion all by myself while he was getting ready to take you to the Kappa Sig Luau. So things have just been a little, well, strained between you and me ever since.
Yeah, but Trisha, have you ever talked to her about that?
No. Neither of us has ever mentioned it. There she is, getting ready to marry Scott McClure, the biggest piece of wet toast I ever saw in my life. Of course, I married Chuck Darby, the second biggest piece of wet toast. Because I thought I wanted some stability. And there's Tommy Valentine, getting ready to knock that little bitch's linen dress off her scrawny little body and fuck her brains out.
You do not.
Yes, I do. I am wearing over $100 worth of extremely uncomfortable lingerie that I specifically picked out for him so he can rip off me.
Let me get this straight. You honestly thought that you were going to sleep with Tommy Valentine today?
Well, yeah. Didn't you read page 67 of The Godfather?
My memory might be a little rosy, but hasn't it been like 10 years since you saw him?
3 months.
Well, Georgian! You better smell your guts, like, right now!
Okay. So when we were at this Lizzie bar, and I saw him, and then we got to talking, and then we got to flirting, and it just felt right.
That's addiction.
Well, I haven't had sex in over a year, so I wouldn't mind making a habit out of it.
What?
Chuck and I don't even sleep in the same room anymore. He sleeps in the guest room.
Why?
I don't know.
You have to have some idea why.
He doesn't talk to me, Trisha. It's like I'm not even there. I told Chuck. Anyways, I told Chuck. And he just looked at me with his fish face, and he's all like, you don't have to tell me everything you do.
Trisha, what did he do? Did Chuck talk to you? Make him go to counseling.
No.
I mean, do you even want to save your marriage?
No. I don't. I don't. I never should have married him in the first place, just like you said. I don't even like him. I don't even love him.